actually by accidentally. Truly this great master, great practitioner, by so much joyful effort and devotion, courage and commitment and practice and meditated and shared and they practice continuous ongoing lineage. Like in the teaching you say, golden mountain, stainless golden mountain lineage. Chain of the stainless golden mountain, well kept in this practice with love, with compassion, with non-violence, with appreciations, with also humble humilities. Kept this teaching. Today we are connected to these teachings. I mean, you are connected, not just today, you are all connected. Therefore, also we should feel great, enjoy. According to Buddhism, in the Buddha teaching, there is no coincidentals. There is cause and conditions. Why we are, since we are connected to such a great teaching, it has a lot of good cause and conditions. Should we appreciate, thankful, grateful, and take the moment, take the opportunity, apply these teachings to the heart. Not just for a few days, few weeks, or few months, or years, and kind of dropping these things. That happened many times in the practice. Those are known as obstacles. Obstacles damaging the path. It's not, it's what is hurting to and more is those who did this, those who do those things. It's happened in the past too. So many times, just kind of like, at the starting time, so enthusiasm, so joy, so love, compassion, and then kind of like doubt and hesitation and skeptical distraction came, all that, and then finally trouble. And then went back to what you started. That is not a fulfilling, not a rewarding. In a way, it is disappointing. Disappointment. Leave this world with a disappointment is one of the worst disasters that we can face in our lives. We should leave this world with joy and appreciation, fulfillment. And if we have some destination to target, that's wonderful. With a destination. And with a goal. And beautiful. Even if we don't have the completely perfect destination, we should leave this world with it, joy and appreciation, fulfillment, with contentment attitudes. That is good. What great master, his own Dunjuruma, said, we should leave this world without any regret, and disappointment. That is not good. And therefore, again, recently, feel happy and joy. That sense we are connected to this great teaching and great, beautiful teachings, love and compassion. This teaching is not, we're not practicing to please someone or to make kind of happy someone. Or we're scared of if we don't do practice or we're not going to happen. We are practicing that for ourselves. Then if we can think for all living beings together with, that will speed up our realization, our understanding. This one. And therefore, this practice for us, we are revealing our own nature, our beautiful, our qualities, our enlightened state, what we have there, and removing and kind of reducing the obstacles, hindrances that we just are making obstacles to us. Hindrances throughout the lifetime or even this lifetime. That is what we are really doing. So, therefore, it is so, with joy and appreciation. And now with this